Don't forget to share the love by subscribing to my channel and contribute with a comment too.
Welcome to Chakra Yoga. We are up to the fifth chakra today, which is the throat chakra. The color here is blue, element ether, and it's located in the center of your throat. So this chakra, not a surprise, has to do with your voice, being able to communicate your needs and communicating clearly. And we are doing poses today to work with flexibility and space in your shoulders, neck, and your chest to really open up this chakra. And if this chakra is blocked or misaligned, according to yoga philosophy, it can show up as physical problem like sore throat, thyroid problems, pain in neck and shoulders, and more mentally, not be able to clearly communicate what you want to say and your needs, and also excessive talking or the opposite, being very quiet. Just a few tidbits about that. So as always, do as you can. Listen to your body. If you need to adjust any pose, do that. And if you need to skip a pose, you can do that too. And more important than anything, have fun. Let's get started. Seated, cross-leg comfortable position. Some of you may want to sit on a blanket. Make sure you don't round your spine. So you want your shoulders over your hips. It's more of a forward tilt here. You can rest your hands on your knees or in your lap. And take two cleansing breaths. So inhale nose and exhale mouth. One more time. And close your eyes if it's comfortable and start breathing in and out through your nose, which we do mostly throughout this practice today. And quickly scan your body, see how you're feeling, if you have any tight spots, any pain, feel energized, and just a mental note of how you feel mentally. And then draw your attention to the throat chakra, the center of your throat. And maybe visualize the color blue or something that is blue, like the sky. And continue and breathe in and out through your nose. We can continue with an ujjayi breath here. You're restricting the back of your throat and sound like the ocean. Continue on your own. So this is a very soothing breath. You can use it in any yoga pose where it feels good, or if you have a lot of thoughts going on, it's a good breath to start. And in some yoga classes, you actually use it throughout the class. It may feel strange if you're new to yoga, but just do what you can. Do three more breaths here. And and go back to normal breathing in and out through your nose. Slowly open your eyes. So start rolling your shoulder forward and up and back. Cross circles. The breathing exercise is also a good way to open up this throat chakra. And circle the opposite direction. And sit neutral position again. Inhale and exhale, chin to chest, stretching the back of your neck. Inhale, look forward. And exhale, chin to chest again. Hold it here for a few breaths. Inhale up, right ear to right shoulder. You can take your right hand and gently press down on your head and left hand to the floor. So stretching the side of your neck here. And switch sides. And cat cow. I'm just going to take that blanket off. So seated cat cow, I'll show that from the side. So inhale, exhale, chin to chest, round your back. So navel into spine. Inhale, arch your back. You can look up or forward. And exhale, round. So move with your own breath. Inhale and exhale. And if you want to do the ujjayi breath again, you can do that. Many times I practice that when I do cat-cow. Warming up your spine. Just a few more. And come to your neutral spine. Coming over. Hands under your shoulders to start with. Spreading your fingers. Then tuck your toes. Hips up and bend your knees and press back. It's kind of a down dog here with bent knees. Take your right heel to the floor, left knee still bending. Press both hands into the floor still. And then switch legs, so left heel into the floor, right knee bent. And then you can just start walking one heel and then the other into the floor, hips sway from side to side. And find stillness in down dog. So you're forming this inverted V. Engage your core. You can look in between your feet, shoulders away from your ears. Maybe heels on the floor. If not, bend your knees. If you want a straight line from your hips to your wrists. If you're new to yoga, this is considered one of the resting poses. If it's too much, you can always come down to child pose. Just rest in any pose that works for you. And from here, walk your hands back, maybe just a few inches. Take your right hand over the outside left side of your left ankle. So you're doing a spinal twist here. Looking over to the left side here. And again, your knees may be bent here. That's fine. And you may not reach your ankle, wherever, maybe calf. And then both hands to the floor and switch to the other side.
And come back. Up on your toes, bend your knees, look forward, and walk to the front of your mat. Relax your head, you can bend your knees. Straighten your right leg. And take your left hand on the floor, or maybe if you don't reach, you can have a block or a book, or just hang here. Take your right arm up, twisting to the right again. Keep your arms reaching up. Take it behind your back. Maybe grab your left inner thigh. Just options. Do what you can. One pose is not better than the other. Not a competition. You're working with your own body. And let's switch. So this time, left arm, reach up, right knee bent, left leg straight. Maybe grab a hold of that inner right thigh. And come down again. Halfway up, you're looking forward. Torso parallel to the floor. Hands on your shins or fingertips on the floor. Fold in half again. Relax your head. Inhale halfway up. Exhale, fold. Inhale halfway up. Bend your knees. Hands on your thighs. Just do cat cow here a few times. Same as we did when we're seated. And slowly come all the way up. Palms together. And hands in front of your heart center. Reach arms up. Grab a hold of your right wrist. Fold over. Side bend. Pressing all four corners of the feet into the floor here. Opening up your right side, your waist, rib cage. Inhale up and switch over to the left, to the right side, sorry. And all the way up, front of your mat. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, hinge at the hips. And come all the way down. Fold in half, relax your head. Inhale, halfway up again. Exhale, fold, bend your knees. And take a big step back with your right leg. Right knee on the floor. Coming to low lunge. So front knee over the front ankle. Reach your arms up, the shoulders down. You're pressing forward here with your hips. Breathe. You can place your hands behind your back. Shoulder blades together. Straighten your arms. Let's see if you can do more of a back bend here. Feel your breath. Where do you feel it? And if your breath is not smooth, maybe back up a little bit in this pose. Too much. And hands to the floor. Tuck your back toes. Plant. Knees on the floor. Bend your elbows back. So your upper arms are parallel to the floor. Don't go any further. And then press forward and up. Straighten your arms. Wrists over your shoulders. Tops of the feet to the floor. Pressing down. Knees off the floor. So high up dog, I mean. And roll over your toes. Engage your core. Come to down dog. Take your right leg behind you, three-legged dog or splits here. Keeps us square to the floor. Bend your right knee and open your right hip to the ceiling. Shoulders are still square to the floor. Breathe. Straighten your leg again. Inhale and exhale. Bend your right knee. Come forward. Right knee to right elbow or somewhere there. Get your core. Inhale, split. And exhale. Take the knee over diagonal. Left elbow. Inhale, middle. And tiger pose, rounding your back, knee in towards forehead. Use your core, breathe. And then step your right foot in between your hands, back leg is straight. Come to high lunge. The front knee over the ankle. Come here, come forward, spring up, hands to the floor. Left leg up, parallel to the floor. Bend your right knee and step your left foot to the front. Halfway up, fold in half. And inhale, reach all the way up, hands in front of your heart center. Doing that one more time, other leg. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale, look forward, bend your knees, big step back, left foot, left knee on the floor, set up low lunge again. So you're not on a tight rope here. Interlace your hands behind your back, shoulder blades together, maybe a back bend. Hands to the floor, tuck your back toes, plank. So you can have your knees on the floor again, like we did last time, or come up to a push-up position. Elbows hugs in, upper arms parallel to the floor, and then press up dog. Down dog, over your toes. Extend left leg behind you, splits. Bend your left knee and open your left hip to the ceiling. Inhale, splits again. Exhale, bend your left knee to left elbow, engage your core. Inhale, splits. Exhale, diagonal. Exhale, splits. And knee in the middle, tiger pose, rounding your back. Step your left foot through. Back heel is off the floor and come to high lunge. Spring up and forward, hands to the floor, right leg parallel to the floor. Bend left knee and step your right foot forward. Fold in half. Inhale, look up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach all the way up and hands in front of your heart center. Let's do it one more time, moving faster this time. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold, bend your knees. Big step back, right foot. Set up, low lunge. Interlace your hands behind your back. Open your heart. Hands to the floor. Tuck your back toes. Hold it here. And push up. Up dog. Down dog. Extend your right leg behind you, three-legged dog. Exhale, bend your knee, come forward. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, left side. Inhale up. And tiger. Step your right foot in between your hands. High lunge. Spring up. And left foot down, fold in half. Halfway up, fold. Inhale, reach out and up. And hands in front of your heart center, one side left. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, fold, bend your knees. Big step back. Left foot. Set up low lunge. Interlace your hands behind your back. Back bend. Hands to the floor, tuck your back toes. And again, knees on the floor, not. Up dog and down dog. Extend your left leg behind you. So I'm skipping, opening the hips on the second time if you haven't noticed. And come forward, knee, and up again. And diagonal. Inhale, splits. Knee in the middle, tiger. Step your left foot between your hands. High lunge. Spring up. And both feet on the floor. Fold in half. Halfway up. Fold again. And reach all the way up. Hands in front of your heart center. Good job. Let's move on. Take a big step back with your right foot, coming into warrior one. The feet are hip width apart here. Back heel is on the floor. Back foot about 45 degree. Front knee over the ankle again, trying not to buckle in or out. Arms out to the sides. Take your right arm under the left, coming to eagle arms here. And again, you may want to have a little back bend here. If that's not comfortable or if you have any pain, just come forward. Never feel any pain in yoga. You may be uncomfortable, but no pain. And come up. Opening up, warrior two. So you may need to widen your stand. Front heel aligned with the back arch, shoulders over your hips. Let's see if you can look over the left hand here. Be mindful of your left knee, straight over the ankle. If that's too much, you can just come up a little. Left palm to the ceiling, come to reverse warrior. Your left knee is still bent. And slowly come up. Straighten both legs, coming into Trikonasana triangle pose. So imagine someone is pulling you forward here. Hips go back. And then place your left hand where it lands. Or if you have a block, you can use that too. Place your hand on. You're trying to stack your shoulders. So don't worry how far down you get your left hand. Maybe look up or down. And slowly come all the way up. Turn to the front again, high lunge. And this time, see if you can spring up and stand on your left leg. Grab a hold of your right knee, maybe. And foot down, good job. Same thing, other side. A big step back with your left foot. Setting up warrior one again, hips forward. 45 degree with the back foot, heel on the floor, arms out. And this time, left arm under the right. Pressing your palms together and your elbows. Maybe back bend here. And come up. Setting up warrior two, widen your stand if you need to. And this time, looking over your right hand. Even in this pose, your core muscles are engaged. The muscles in your arms, your fingers are engaged. Strong legs. And breathe. Right palm, face up. Keep that bent knee where it is and open up to reverse warrior. Check in with your breath again, still smooth and steady. And come up. Straighten both legs, look over your right hand. Triangle. Stacking your shoulders as much as you can. One more inhale and exhale here. And slowly come up, turn to the front again, high lunge, back leg straight, and spring up, stand on your right leg, hold the left knee, and both feet to the floor, feet about hip width apart, palms facing forward. Close your eyes if it's comfortable. If you can find the center of your feet here. Standing tall. Just breathe all the way from the soles of your feet, through your legs, through your spine, and to the crown of your head. And then exhale from the crown of your head all the way down. Inner focus. Connect to see how your body is feeling now, where your thoughts are. Slowly open your eyes. Let's move on. Coming in to tree pose. So always when you do balance, engage your core, it really helps. So let's stand on your right foot, spread your toes, bend your left knee and open up here. As always, options, you can have the toes on the left foot on the floor, maybe on the side of your calf, or over the knee, or all the way up. Do what works for you. And then look at something in front of you that doesn't move, that helps with a balance, called drishti in yoga. Maybe arms up, maybe even look up, maybe even close your eyes, play with it. Maybe you're a moving tree, doesn't matter if you come out of the pose. Breathe here. If you're holding your breath, adjust the pose. Do this. Palms in front of your heart center, and see if you can take your left ankle above your right knee, bending your right knee, and sit down. So you're kind of forming a four, oops, with your legs. Stay here. Breathe, sit down. Maybe sit a little deeper. You may feel this in your right shin. And finally, I know all of you may not be able to place your hands on the floor. You can use blocks or books, but take your left foot and cross it. So both feet are on the floor. Relax your head here. And walk your hands out to the right side. You may be hanging here too, that's totally fine. Inhale to the middle and walk your hands over to the left side. As I say, you don't have to be flexible to yoga. That's not the objective of doing yoga. Something that will come with time. Come to the middle. See if you can press both feet into the floor and come all the way up. And uncross your legs. Take it out. Inhale, exhale. Same thing, left side. So this time, pressing your left foot into the floor, right knee out. And then find where you want to place that right foot. So you're breathing here. Where are your thoughts? If this is a difficult pose for you, just be kind to yourself, no judgment. Front of your heart center, right ankle above the left knee, bend your left knee and sit down here. You're flexing your right foot. Just do what you can, don't worry if this is not accessible for you. And then right foot to the floor, fold in half, relax your head. And move over to your left side. Inhale and exhale, hands to your right side. Come to the middle, press your feet into the floor, and come up. Let's take a cleansing breath. So inhale through your nose and exhale through the mouth. One more time. Any tension you have, just leave your body. Squatting position. So feet a little wider than the hips. Having your knees point out. Come down and sit. Elbows on the inside of the knees, pressing out. And the elbows press in. your heels are not on the floor. You can sit on a bolster or a block or something, or use your yoga mat. Roll, roll, roll. The more you roll, the higher it's going to be, and then put your heels on top. Once you're there, come to stillness. You can even close your eyes. Long, nice spine. And you have a string on the top of your head, pulling you up. Too much, come out, and then try and do it again. The more you practice, the easier it will become. Learning patience on this journey. And slowly tap it out, maybe working you back. So lay down, feet about hip width apart. Tuck your chin, arms alongside your body, palms facing down. Use your back muscles. Inhale, come up. Legs, arms off the floor. Breathing. And slowly come down. Turn your head to one side. Palms facing up. Maybe move your hips a little to release any tension. Set number two.
Tuck your chin again. Interlace your fingers. Shoulder blades together. Inhale, legs up. Arms straight. Long neck. Breathe.
And come down, turn your head to the other side, palms facing up. Third variation, bow pose. So bend your knees, grab hold of your ankles from the outside, and then flex your feet. Inhale, come up. You're pressing back with your shins. And if this is not accessible, do one of the ones we just did. Breathe here. And slowly come down. Palms on top of each other and forehead on top. And again, maybe move your hips to release tension in your back. And press yourself up. Camel pose, another one to open your heart area and the shoulders, the knees, hip width apart, hands on your sacrum, shoulder blades together. You're pressing your hips forward here. For some of you, this may be enough. Stay here, look forward. If you don't have a neck problem, if you may wanna get your head back here. Up to you. That's option number one. Option two, tucking your toes, grabbing hold of your heels. Again, press hips forward, same thing. Look forward or head hangs. And the third, most advanced pose, grab a hold of your heels with tops of the feet on the floor. Press forward, and the same thing with your head. So see where your breath here. Don't go further than you need to go. One pose again is much better than the other. It's all about what's good for you. Listen to your inner voice. Mm-hmm. Two more breaths here. And if you're all the way back, hands on your sacrum again, and slowly come up. Just rest in child pose. You can have your knees wide or together. Rest with your head down. Feel your breath all the way to your belly. Where in your life you have clear communication? Where is it easy? And how's the feeling when communication is easy? Slowly come up and over. We are going to sit. Take your right knee out to the side, left leg forward, and flex that left foot. So from the side too. Sitting straight, you can even have a strap under the ball of the foot here. Inhale and exhale, heart to the front. Front foot is flexed the whole time. You can stay there. Some of you may relax your head down. Forward folds, really soothing for your nervous system. A way to calm you down. Don't go too far in this pose. Check in with your breath. After a few breaths, your body usually relaxes as you get deeper into the pose. And slowly come up. Right foot on the floor. So under your sitting bone here. Take your right arm forward. And see if you can reach in front of your shin and reach back. Left arm back. Maybe your hands interlace. Or you can always use a strap too. I'll show you from the side. So right arm on the inside of the right knee, back and back. So you can hold the strap here if that's easier for you. Once you find that pose, relax your head, fold forward. No worries, this is a new pose, just do what you can. Slowly come up. Let's switch sides. Flex your right foot. Inhale, exhale, come forward. Again, you can use the strap if you want to under the ball of the foot. And then relax your head maybe. All the way up, left foot on the floor, heel into the buttocks. Take your left arm on the inside of the knee, front of the shin, strap, you need to relax your head, fold forward. And slowly come up. Seated spinal twist. Bend your right knee. Left leg over. So you want both sitting bones on the floor. If that's not happening, just extend your right leg and flex the foot. From here, take your left hand behind you, close to your body, right arm up, inhale and exhale, and twist to the left side, looking over your left shoulder here. You can hug that left knee in. Some of you may be able to have your right elbow on the outside of that knee. Some of you may be able to bind. In your inner organs, your digestive system is not here. And twists are also good for your nervous system. Calming. And come forward. Let's switch legs. Left knee in, right leg over, or straighten that left leg, flex the foot. Right arm behind you, inhale and exhale, and twist to the right side. And slowly come forward on your back. Into bridge pose. So feet hip width apart, heels in towards the buttocks. Arms alongside your body, palms facing down. Press both feet into the floor and hips up to the ceiling. Make sure you have a little space in between your chin and your chest. You can stay with the palms on the floor, otherwise interlace your hands and walk your shoulder blades as close as you can. Imagine also that you have a ball in between your knees. So you're pressing in here, inward rotation. The blockage of your throat chakra can also show up as jaw problems. Relax your jaw here. And slowly come down. Take your right ankle over your left knee, or above your left knee, I should say. Left knee off the floor. Right hand in between your legs. And the left hand on the outside of the left knee. And press that left knee in towards your chest. You feel a good hip opener here. Two more breaths here. And left foot on the floor. Do some core work here. So keep your right ankle where it is. Left foot off the floor again. So left shin bone kind of parallel to the floor here, 90 degree with the knee. Place your hands behind your back and see if you can just crunch here. Small crunches. Breathe. Let's continue. Let's do four more. One, two, three, four, and then hold it up. Hold, engage your core. And come down. One more time. bridge pose. Feet hip width apart. Press your feet in, hips up. Maybe interlace your hands again. Shoulder blades together. Slowly come down. Take your left ankle over right knee. And flex both feet. Right knee in. Working your left hip here. Two more breaths here. Right foot to the floor. Get ready for core work. Hands behind your head, interlace your fingers. 90 degree with that right knee. And just start crunch. Four, three, two, one, hold it. And all the way down. Hug your knees in. Maybe move from side to side. Hands behind your knees. Roll on your spine a few times. And come all the way up to boat pose. Maybe let go of your knees. Hold it here. And breathing exercise. We're going to do the bee breath today. Soothing, calming. So you're sounding like a bee. So the first variation. Just gonna close your eyes and sound like this. So hold the breath or do the B breath as long as you're breathing out. So let's do it. Inhale. Just normal breath after that. Second variation. This time you're actually covering your ears just slightly, not pushing too hard. Now you can put your index and middle finger on your forehead and maybe the ring fingers in between your eyebrows. You won't be able to hear me when you do this. So we're inhaling again and then long exhale. So place the fingers in the right position and inhale. Hands on your knees. Just normal breathing in and out through the nose. Sit with it, see how it feels. And final relaxation. If you want to continue and meditate seated, you can do that. Otherwise, come down, corpse pose. Let your feet hang out to the sides. palms facing up, shoulders relaxed, jaw relaxed, the whole body relaxed. Relaxing your feet, your ankles, relaxing the front of your legs, shins, knees, quads, relaxing the back of the legs, calves, hamstrings. Relax your hips, your belly, just heart. Relax your lower back, your upper back. Relax your fingers, hands, wrists. Relax your forearms, your upper arms, your shoulders. Relax your neck, your jaw. Relax your face muscles, top of the head, the whole body is relaxed. Start deepening, lengthening your breath, and bring your awareness back to your room. Moving your toes, your fingers. Reaching your arms over your head, pointing your toes, stretch, and come over to the right side. Take a few breaths there. And when you're ready, come up to your seated, comfortable position. Eyes still closed. And as we started the class, let's scan the body again. See if you feel any difference. Where your mind, your thoughts are. And thank yourself for being here, taking this time, and being able to take this time for yourself. It will benefit not only you, but everyone around you. It will have a ripple effect throughout the world. Words and speech can shape your day and your relationships. Today, before you speak or write a message, ask yourself what you really want to convey, and if you're ready to convey it in the best possible way. Your words carry power, and used with care, that power can be an uplifting force of good. Try to choose your words with care, empowering yourself and the people around you. Palms together in front of your heart center. Thank you so much for being here, sharing your practice with me. Bow your head to seal the practice. Have a beautiful day, everyone. Namaste.
Don't forget to share the love by subscribing to my channel and contribute with a comment too.